Rain water can be scarce in the desert, so when it does rain, some rattlesnakes seize the moment.
Let's get over to Debo, the science pro, to find out how these reptiles collect that water and save it for later, something we've never thought about here.
You know, what's interesting about all this is that if you think about how long snakes have been on this earth for, there's a reason, because they can adapt. And these snakes out west, these western diamondback rattlesnakes, the cousins of the eastern diamondback, they have found a way to adapt. But and here's what they do. We obviously know they don't get much rain out there in the arid desert, desert southwest and stuff. So what they've been doing, they noticed that these, when it starts to rain or it's about to rain, these snakes come out, okay? They flatten their body and they often form a tight coil so they can maximize the area for water gathering. But they noticed the raindrops sit on top of the scales. They find a way to flatten out their scales and they use their scales to collect rainwater and then drink it off their own body. Now, what they did was they compared this to a couple of other snakes that live out there and realized that when those snakes try to get water, it puddles on top of their body and falls off. But little water droplets stick to the scales. There's some type of stickiness on those scales, which allows water droplets to just gather, and then the snake can drink out of those. And that is what has allowed the western diamondback rattle, amongst other snakes, to be able to live out there in the arid desert. And it was a study that they had done. I just think it's amazing to see how different species can live and they can adapt. Because if you think about it, if they don't adapt, guess what? They're gone. So that's what they do. They have some kind of a sticky substance on their scales.
That's crazy.
Which allows water droplets. And they noticed it too. They actually did a study where they put water on it. They put it in a controlled setting. You can see the water droplets just stacking up.
I don't want to be that guy.
On their, that's what I was thinking too. On their scales, whereas other snakes, it puddles and rolls off. So you know, they have found, whether that's natural or whether they developed that, we don't know that yet, but it's just cool.
This is one of those things that you found, or whoever found this for us, that you never in your life have thought about. How do snakes get water? You didn't think they even needed water. Well, and now I'm completely fascinated by it.
Well, if you think about it, I mean, everyone's thinking of their tongue, right? When they were sticking their tongue out.
They go to the lake and they drink.
Very little water out west. Yes. They can't waste it. And they have found a way to maximize the gathering of it. And a few times it does rain. And that's how the western diamondback rattler stays alive.
And now I want to know, now that you've opened this can of snakes, I want to know how long they can go without having water.
I'm going to Google that real quick.
No, don't. We'll find it. But you know what I'm thinking? I mean, like, if there's like a real drought, how long they can go?
No, that's a good point. I will get back to you with that answer, I promise. How does that sound?
I know you will. But,
right. I just think it's amazing how different animals can adapt
to
where they are. You know, and if you if you go back to the dinosaurs, they couldn't adapt, right?
Yeah.
So they were gone. And it just goes to show you that there are some species, alligators, another one, they adapt. They're very good at adapting.
It's cool. It's a cool subject.
Yeah.
I'm glad you did this today. That was fun. Thank you, man.
Yep.